Dear students, today let us discuss independence of events and theorems based on it. So these are some important points related to probability which we have seen in previous lectures and are useful to you for MCQ type questions. Now you recall that in first lecture we have defined independent events as the events are said to be independent if occurrence of one of them does not affect occurrence of the others. Now we can put this definition of independence of events through conditional probability as two events A and B are said to be independent if the conditional probability of A when B has already happened is same as unconditional probability of A and conditional probability of B given that A has already occurred is same as unconditional probability of B. So this again we can put in the form of multiplication theorem as two events A and B are said to be independent if and only if probability of A intersection B is equal to probability of A into probability of B. So this equation is very useful while solving numerical problems based on addition law, multiplication law, as well as other numerical problems on probability. Now let us see pairwise independence. The group of events is said to be pairwise independent if for every pair the events are independent. In particular, three events A, B and C are said to be pairwise independent if the following three equations hold. Equation 1 is probability of A intersection B is equal to probability of A into probability of B. Probability of A intersection C is equal to probability of A into probability of C. And probability of B intersection C is equal to probability of B into probability of C. So that means all possible pairs should be independent. Now let us see mutual independence. The events are said to be mutually independent if they are pairwise independent as well as all are independent. In particular, the three events A, B and C are said to be mutually independent if these four equations hold. So the first three equations are the equations of pairwise independence and the last fourth equation is the condition for all are independent. So that is probability of A intersection B intersection C is equal to product of their respective probabilities. So if these four equations holds, then and then we can say that A, B and C are mutually independent events. Now let us see the important theorems. Theorem number one, if A and B are independent events, then probability of A union B is equal to 1 minus probability of A complement into probability of B complement. Now for the proof, let us assume that A and B are independent. That is probability of A intersection B is equal to probability of A into probability of B. So this equation holds for independent events. Now let us consider by addition law probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. So which is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A into probability of B. This is because of independence, this equation. Again, so by taking probability of B as a common factor from these two terms, we have probability of B into 1 minus probability of A. So therefore, this becomes 1 minus probability of A complement plus probability of B into probability of A complement. So by taking probability of 1 minus probability of A complement common here. So this will become 1 minus probability of A complement into 1 minus probability of B. So which is equal to 1 minus probability of A complement into probability of B complement, and which proves the equation probability of A union B is equal to 1 minus probability of A complement into probability of B complement. Second theorem, if A and B are independent events, then A and B complement are also independent. So for the proof, let A and B are independent events, that means this equation holds. And to show that A and B complement are independent means we have to prove probability of A intersection B complement is equal to probability of A into probability of B complement. Now to prove this equation, let us express event A as union of two exclusive events A intersection B and A intersection B complement as A equal to A intersection B complement union A intersection B. Therefore, its probability is probability of A is equal to probability of A intersection B complement plus probability of A intersection B because of exclusiveness and axiom number 3 of axiomatic definition. So this gives us probability of A intersection B complement. So that means left hand side of this equation equal to probability of A minus probability of A intersection B. The other interpretation of this one is probability that exactly A will happen is given by the theorem number 3 after axiomatic definition of probability, that is equal to probability of A minus probability of A intersection B. Now let us use here the independence, that is probability of A into probability of B, and by taking probability of A as common factor, this gives us probability of A into 1 minus probability of B, that is equal to probability of A into probability of B complement. So this equation implies that event A and B complement are also independent. That means if A and B are independent, then A and B complement are also independent events. So theorem number 3, similar type of the theorem, if A and B are independent events, then A complement and B are also independent. So we can prove this theorem similar to that of previous theorem in the same manner. Okay, now let us see the theorem number 4. If A and B are independent events, then A complement and B complement are also independent events. So for the proof, let us consider A and B as independent events. That means this equation holds. Probability of A intersection B is equal to probability of A into probability of B. Now to show that A complement and B complement are also independent, we have to prove that probability of A complement intersection B complement equal to probability of A complement into probability of B complement. Now consider the left hand side here. So probability of A complement intersection B complement, that is equal to, so using De Morgan's rule, we can write probability of intersection of complements is equal to probability of complement of union. So because of De Morgan's rule, and again by complementation, this is 1 minus probability of A union B. And by addition law of probability, we can write this as 1 minus probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. Again, using the equation star, that is independence in this equation, this gives us, so equal to 1 minus probability of A minus probability of B plus probability of A into probability of B. So by taking probability of B as a common factor from these two terms, so this gives us 1 minus probability of A minus probability of B into 1 minus probability of B. Again, by taking 1 minus probability of A as common factor, it reduces to 1 minus probability of A into 1 minus probability of B, that is equal to probability of A complement into probability of B complement. And this shows that A complement and B complement are also independent events. Hence the proof. Next theorem, if the events A and B are independent, events depend only if probability of A given B is equal to probability of A given B complement. So we can prove such type of statements if and only if type statements in two parts. So we may consider the first, we may assume the first condition and prove the second condition in first part. In second part, we may assume the second condition and prove the first condition. So for the proof, let us consider the first part. So let us assume that A and B are independent. So that means probability of A intersection B is equal to probability of A into probability of B. And let us prove that probability of A given B is equal to probability of A given B complement. So let us consider here the left hand side, probability of A given B is equal to, by the definition of conditional probability, this is probability of A intersection B divided by probability of B. So we can use independence here, and therefore it becomes probability of A into probability of B divided by probability of B. Finally, it gives us equal to probability of A. So we call this as equation number one. Now consider right hand side, equal to probability of A given B complement. Again, by the definition of conditional probability, it is probability of A intersection B complement divided by probability of B complement. So again, from the theorem number 3, after axiomatic definition, probability that exactly A will happen is given by probability of A intersection B complement, and it is given by probability of A minus probability of A intersection B. Again, using independence here, so this will give us probability of A minus probability of A into probability of B. And again, by taking probability of A as common factor, it reduces to 1 minus probability of B. 1 minus probability of B is B probability of B complement. So probability of B complement gets cancelled, and it reduces to finally probability of A. So we call this as equation number 2. So from equation 1 and equation 2, as the right hand sides are equal, that is equal to probability of A, the left hand sides are also equal. So that means probability of A intersection B is equal to probability of A probability of A given B equal to probability of A given B complement. So this proves the first part of this equation. Now for second part, let us assume the second condition, probability of A given B is equal to probability of A given B complement. Let us prove the independence here, probability of A intersection B is equal to probability of A into probability of B. So let us consider this equation here, and by the definition of conditional probability, that can be expanded like this. And by taking cross multiplication both sides, so it gives us probability of A intersection B into 1 minus probability of B equal to probability of B into probability of A minus probability of A intersection B. Therefore, this gives us probability of A intersection B minus probability of B into probability of A intersection B equal to probability of A into probability of B minus probability of B into probability of A intersection B. So this term, probability of B into probability of A intersection B, probability of B into probability of A intersection B, gets cancelled from both the sides, and it reduces to probability of A intersection B is equal to probability of A into probability of B. So that means A and B are independent events. Hence, from part first and part second, the events A and B are independent events if and only if probability of A given B is equal to probability of A given B complement. Hence, the proof. Now let us see one theorem related to mutual independence. If A, B and C are mutually independent events, then A union B and C are also independent events. So for that, let us consider A, B and C as mutually independent events. That means these four equations holds regarding to the independence. And here we have to prove probability of A union B intersection C equal to probability of A union B into probability of C. So for that, let us consider the left hand side here, probability of A union B intersection C equal to, so let us apply the distributive law here and we can write this term as probability of A intersection C union with B intersection C. Again, there is union, so probability of union by using addition law, we can write probability of union is equal to probability of first term, probability of A intersection C, plus probability of second term, probability of B intersection C, minus probability of intersection, so that is minus probability of A intersection C, intersection B intersection C. So again, that can be written as probability of A intersection C plus probability of B intersection C minus probability of A intersection B intersection C. Now let us apply the mutual independence in this equation. So that means let us substitute the equation number 1, 2, 3 and 4 in this equation. It reduces to probability of A into probability of C plus probability of B into probability of C minus probability of A into probability of B into probability of C. And by taking probability of C as a common factor, it reduces to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection probability of B. And due to independence, we can write probability of A into probability of B as probability of A intersection B. And by the addition law, we can write this bracket as probability of A union B into probability of C. So that means A union B and C are also independent events, hence the proof. In next lecture, we shall see some numerical problems based on the independence of events. Thank you. Thank you very much.